Life is full of twists and turns. Life is full of twists and turns. Twist and turn, twist and turns. We are the children of God. Twist and turns, twist and turns. Life is full of twists and turns. Smadu.
Hello, hello. Ta-ra-ra. Hello, hello, children. How are you doing today? I hope you are doing good. I am also doing fine. Welcome to our religious activity lesson. And today we are going to learn about fruits of the Holy Spirit. And today we are going to look about goodness. Remember, you have tackled love and joy. So let's sing a song before we start our lesson. Let the goodness of God flood in my heart. Let the goodness of God flood in my heart. Let the goodness of God flood in my family. Let the goodness of God flow in my friends. Let the goodness of God flow in my teachers. Let the goodness of God flow in my heart. Family, flood in my friends, flood in my school, flood in my teachers. So today we are going to learn about a fruit of the Holy Spirit, that is goodness. And what is goodness? Goodness is the quality of being morally good. Goodness is the quality of being morally good. Goodness is the quality of being morally good and also doing the right thing to please God. Alright? Yes, you should always do right things to please our God and our Father. For example, when you are said by your mom or your dad, go and bring me that cup. You should go and bring it, okay? That is to be good. You should show kindness to one another. Not only your parent, but also here in school, okay? You should show kindness to your friends and even to your teachers. When your teacher tells you to do that homework, complete that assignment, you should complete it, okay? When your teacher tells you not to make noise in your class, you should not make noise. That is being good. And by doing that, you are pleasing the teacher. And also you're pleasing the God. God wants children who are good, okay? Are you good yourself? Do you do the right thing at the right time? Yeah, you should do the right thing at the right time. When you're told to do something by even your senior sister or your senior brother, you should do it. When you are sad, just don't complain. Don't say, mom, I can't go. Mom, I can't. Oh, mom, oh, mom, oh, mom. No. You should go and bring what he has sent you or what she has sent you. Okay? Yeah, not complaining. Okay? Yes. So that is being good. And being good is the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Remember, there are so many fruits of the Holy Spirit. For example, we have love, we have joy, we have peace. We have kindness, okay? We have patience. Yeah, so those ones will learn it as the time goes by. Today I wanted us to learn about them, their goodness. And we see, we'll find a verse from the Bible, from the book of John, which is talking about goodness. It's a verse from the Bible, from the book of John. from the book of John, chapter 10, verses 11. Okay, we learn verses from the Bible, memorizing one by one. So the Bible is telling us that I am the good shepherd. I am the good shepherd who is willing to die for his sheep. Learning verses from the Bible, memorizing one by one. Learning verses from the Bible, memorizing one by one. John 10 verse 11. The Bible is telling us that I am the good shepherd who is willing to die for his sheep. And here, who is the good shepherd? Yes, Jesus is the good shepherd. Jesus here is our shepherd, and he is willing to die for us. For us, we are his sheep. The Bible is telling us that he is willing to die for us. That's the quality of being good, right? Yes. Jesus, our shepherd, willing to die for his sheep. That means he is, that is a quality of being good. And that is one of the fruit of the Holy Spirit, right? Yeah. So today, I wanted us to learn about the fruit of the Holy Spirit, that is goodness, right? So in our next lesson, we'll continue learning more fruits of the Holy Spirit because there are so many, right? I hope you have enjoyed our lesson and see you next time. And thank you so much for watching. God bless you. Bye.